This is a piece of flint that I dug this summer, and it's about 15 inches long, but it has like a problem here as far as maybe snapping coming off, and there's a couple little open areas that may affect it, but we'll see what happens. I haven't done any of these for probably 15 years, so we'll see if I can do one now. So get some abrasion on. Let's see where. I'll try this billet for a while. And it's really slow because, as you can see, I took this small flakes off of there. And it takes a lot of series of those to get this thinned down because it's a little thick here compared to back here. Anytime you have an area that it's too thick, heavier at the tip, you know, you're going to snap it a lot easier. So this to me is probably one of the more boring parts of it because it takes forever to get it, the tip and the base down. So you can really start napping it. And try to stabilize it a little bit on your knee, and when it gets to I get real serious, I might even lay it up against my drawer there to keep it from snapping. Just like now, I lay it up against that edge when I'm right on the tip, because that way it'll stabilize it where it doesn't want to snap as easy. See, I've already shortened it because of this section here. Worked. see, they don't go very deep. They just go far enough to get a little roll over the top of the flint. See, I got a little crystal hanging in there. I don't do many of these big ones. It takes about five times more concentration to do the thing. I don't like to be that focused on them anymore. So we're still working on that tip, and you can see it's not done a lot yet. Crack coming in through there. Should hold. One thing about when you have a tough spot like this, you don't have to take a lot of big hits. You can see that I'm not coming way back here and cranking it up. I'm pretty much just a tap. Well, that one's pretty stubborn, but. It'll flake now. That's pretty thick there yet, but. Thank you. see it's starting to shape. I'm getting flakes. I never get in a big hurry to run these all the way into there until later on. That end up against there so I can flake on the tip. Even though it's still thick, you cannot take thick flakes. You gotta be thin like a potato chip. That's the one thing to remember. If you wanna keep them intact, they gotta be thin as a potato chip. That's what I was always told. And you can see that tip is starting to get thinner. You know, when you're the thick as it is, you think, well, these flakes shouldn't be that precise, but if you hit them where you're aiming at, it saves a lot of problems. little bit of a crack there, but I think I got it now. It's, you can still see a little bit of it. So you probably wonder, what am I going to do with that? What I'm going to do is try to work this side here first. So the way to deal with, there's little cracks, and you can see it's just with the edge of the ledge. So I'm doing is just bringing this edge toward this flat side that I want to place.